All right, once again, we've got the lawnmower in the garage today. And as you can tell from the title of the video, we're gonna be throwing some Seafoam through this thing. Basically, the quick history on this mower, bought it about 3 years ago. So this is the third summer now that I'll be using it. And towards the end of last summer, it was starting to take, you know, 4 or 5 tries before it would start. And wasn't running very well at first. It was changing idle speeds, whatnot. So figure before I start trying to take apart the carburetor and all this and cleaning that out, that I try out some Seafoam. I'm sure everybody's heard of it. I've got some friends at work that live and die by this, and quite a few of them said run Seafoam through the motor. So that's what we're gonna do today. So basically, there's two ways you can use Seafoam, and we're gonna do both ways today. I have to mow my lawn, so what we're gonna do is we're going to take the Seafoam and we're going to add it to the gas before putting it into the mower. And that's going to get it all through the gas lines, all that stuff cleaned out. And then once the motor is nice and hot, when I'm done, we're going to take the Seafoam and we're going to dump it through the air intake, through the carb, and gum all that stuff out. And we'll see how much better the lawnmower runs. And yeah, so obviously, like anything else, you gotta read the directions on it. My one pet peeve so far with Seafoam, everything is in gallons and ounces, and that's great for a lot of people, but this guy lives in Canada, and our measurements are liters and milliliters, so doesn't really help me. But anyways, so we're gonna open this up. And what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of eyeball this in. The good thing from a little bit of research I did online before making the video, Seafoam is petroleum based. You really can't add too much to your gas. So we're just going to kind of toss some in. Got about 8 liters in there, so that should be enough. And the mower right now is empty from last time I mowed the lawn. So we're going to take the gas, put it in the mower. I'm gonna go mow my lawn. Obviously not gonna film any of that. And when I'm done that, the motor will be nice and hot, and we'll start dumping Seafoam in through the carburetor, and we'll see how that works for us. All right, so as you can see, the lawn is mowed. So the next step with this Seafoam stuff is you're gonna wanna remove your air filter. This will give you direct access to your carburetor where we're going to be dumping the Seafoam. So flathead screwdriver takes this off, and this part pulls off, and this is where we're going to be dumping in the Seafoam. And just kind of as a side note, this is your all the air intake on the mower, and basically it acts like an air filter for your car. And if you don't really do a lot of maintenance on your lawnmower, this can get clogged up with air. It hasn't rained in Saskatchewan that much this year. It's the end of May, middle of May, and it's only rained once since the snow is here. So it is dry as can be outside. And it just happened the one time it did rain was last week. We got 3 days of rain, and it hasn't rained since. So I don't know how good you can see this, but my air intake is clogged right up. And I stopped halfway through mowing my lawn and actually unclogged it and started again, and it's still clogged up. Just one of those things that when you have a mower, take this out periodically and clean it. I'm gonna bring it in the house after, run it under the water. It's just a sponge, but just kind of as a side note, don't neglect your air cleaner for your lawnmower. So basically what you're gonna do is you're gonna start up your mower. If you have a buddy that can come and hold your safety device down, fantastic. I'm doing this by myself. So I'm just gonna wrap some duct tape around here, and that'll hold it down. So just a little piece of duct tape. Yeah, it's a safety device, I get that. But we're not really mowing up hills or anything, so this isn't gonna cause any issues with us. So next thing we're gonna do is start this lawnmower up. And once we get her running, we'll start dumping some Seafoam right in there. And from what I understand, we're gonna get some white smoke pouring out of it. while I was mowing the lawn with the Seafoam and the gas, there was times under load when I'd hit tall grass or whatnot, a little bit of white smoke would puff out. So that's just the Seafoam going through the system. So let's get this thing started and start adding some Seafoam. All right, so we got the mower running. And now we're gonna grab the Seafoam, which I probably should have grabbed before I started the mower. Now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna pour a little bit in at a time, see what happens. We're gonna do this a few times, and then we're gonna pour enough to stall the engine. So we put enough that the engine eventually stalled. Now we're going to give it about 20 minutes. And once 20 minutes are done, start it up, clear the rest of the stuff out of the motor. And we're done. As you can see, it makes a lot of smoke. Neighbors are probably going to wonder what you're doing. But this is all normal. It's what it's supposed to do. Alright, so it's been about 20 minutes now. And we're going to give the lawnmower a start. I anticipate it's probably going to take a couple pulls of the cord to get it going because it's gummed up right now with Seafoam. But yeah, we'll let it rip and see what happens. So we'll give 3 primes on the prime button and pull the cord, see what happens. Alright, and there you have it. That's my little bit of a Seafoam how to do, and I'm going away to Regina tomorrow, so I'll be gone for a few days. When I get back, we'll see how this thing starts up, if it's taking 4 or 5 pulls again, or if it starts first time. I'll let you guys know in the comment section. Possibly I might do an opinion video. I'm not sure. We'll see how she all works, but that's basically all there is to doing the Seafoam clean out of your lawnmower, boat motor, whatever other motors you might have, 2 or 4 cycle, you can put in your car, your truck. I'm not a Seaboy fanboy by any means, but this is a neat way to try it out and see if I like it. If I like it, hey, I have no problems telling everybody I like it. If I don't think it did anything, then I'll let you know that as well. So that's it for this video. If this video helped you, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. I'd love to have you guys check out my future videos. Thank you, and we'll talk to you later.